Hello friends, today we are going to see the indexing method which is used in universal dividing head or any type of dividing head. In that we'll cover the direct or rapid indexing, plain or a simple indexing. So there are different methods of indexing. First one is the direct or a rapid indexing, plain or a simple indexing. So today we'll cover only two methods: compound indexing, differential indexing, and angular indexing. Direct or a rapid indexing. For direct indexing, the worm and worm wheel of an index head is disengaged. It means that in direct indexing, the index plate is directly mounted on the dividing head spindle. Means there is no worm and worm wheel in the rapid indexing. And if it is, then we can disengage also. So spring-loaded pin can be pushed in any one of the hole to the spindle with frame. Okay. So while indexing, the indexing crank pin is withdrawn from the hole of the index plate, then the pin is engaged directly after the work and index plate are rotated. So in rapid indexing, we are using a index plate having a 24 holes, and this which will be divisible by 24, 12, 8, 6, 4, 3, 2. It means that if you want to divide any periphery into the two parts, three parts, or four parts, five part, six part, eight part, 12 part, then we can use the direct or a rapid indexing method. So this is a plate which having a 24 holes. Direct indexing is used for milling a square or a hexagonal nut and bolts on the milling machine. So for that we required one formula, which is called as an index crank movement, ICM is equal to N by T. Here, N is nothing but the number of holes in the index plate, and T is nothing but the number of required division. Means you have to divide the periphery into six parts or eight parts like that. So you can see here one example I have taken. This is a nut in which there are six, you can see, there are six, that periphery is divided into six part. Okay, so how it is possible there? So as per the formula, that is the number of holes on the index plate divided by number of required division. So in this case, we required a six division. So 24 divided by six will be the four. So we should move the pin by four holes after each teeth in cut. Right. So this is how we can use the direct or a rapid indexing, which is a very simple method. But there is a limitation here. Means we can't divide into, suppose you want to divide into seven part or a nine part. Okay. So it is not possible in a direct indexing. Plain or a simple indexing. Plain or simple indexing involves the use of universal dividing head, which here you can see in a on the screen. We are used the universal type of dividing head. It is used when it is required to divide the circle into more number of parts that is not possible by rapid indexing. Means you can see in the rapid indexing, there is a limitation. You can divide any circle into 24 parts or 12 parts, right? Then the six part, eight parts, like that. Here, instead of that, if you want to divide other than that, it is possible in a plain or a simple indexing. So here the worm and the worm wheel, they are both engaged with the spindle, and worm wheel having a 40 number of teeth. You can see in the diagram. Now one complete turn of the index crank causes a spindle and the work to rotate 1/14th of the turn. That is a 40:1. What it means? Means If I give a 40 turn to this index crank, then the workpiece will rotate or give, take a one complete rotation. Means that is a 360 degree. But for that, we have to rotate the index crank how many times? 40 times, 40. Now the index plate, there are different circle of holes are patented by the Brown and Sharp manufacturing company. So how they are designed that plate? So plate number one, which having the circle of holes 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, and other plate that is 21, 23, 27, 29, 31, 33, and plate three has design 37, 39, 41, 43, 47, 40. So like that, the Brown and Sharp manufacturing company has done the design of the index plate. For that, again, the formula is that index crank moment is equal to 40 by N. So N is nothing but a number of division required on the work. So for that, I have taken one example. Find the index moment for cutting 25 teeth on the spur gear blank. Means one, if I take a gear blank, I have to generate that 25 teeth. So for that, the index crank moment formula is 40 by N. So 40, how many teeth we require? 25. So it is, we are dividing by 25. So here we are getting the 115 by 25. If you do the fractional calculation, right? So 1 is nothing but the quotient and 15 is the remainder and 25 is the divisor. So like that, again, I have divide 15 by 25 by 5. So 5 threes are 15, 5 fives are 25. So like that, and we are getting 3 by 5. But student, there is no plate having a 5 holes. So for that, what you have to do? So 3 into 3 divided by 5. Means 3 by 5 is already there. So we are multiplied by 3, right? To the numerator as well as the denominator. So we are getting the value 9 by 15. So as per the index plate, we are having the plate hole of 15 circle. So now it is possible. So how we can do, what it means that the index moment will be one complete turn of the index crank and 9 holes on a 15 hole index crank. So I will tell you what is the meaning of that. So first of all, I will select the whole circle of the 15, right? You can see in this diagram here also, or here means 15 whole circle you have to first select. Okay, so you have to give the one complete rotation. One means you have to give the one complete rotation of the index crank. Okay, and then after that, suppose I'm starting from this position, start position, I have to move again to the ninth hole. Okay, so I'll move to the ninth hole and I insert that index pin into the ninth hole, and then we can exactly produce a 25 number of teeth on the gear blank. So this is a method of plain or a simple indexing.